Do you want to learn how to make a Subway sandwich at home or that Subway style bread at home? Well, today I'm going to show you how to do that. But before we get started, let's look at the B-roll first. We're gonna learn how to make the most amazing Subway bread. It's actually better than Subway itself. This is also known as a super soft French bread. Full detailed recipe in metric and imperial units is in the description below. To make this bread, you're gonna need about 4 cups or 500 grams of bread flour. You can use all-purpose flour, but I think using bread flour will allow the bread to rise even higher and allow it to hold its shape. I don't know why, but everything in slow motion looks amazing. Do you agree? But anyways, let's get back to the recipe. Now we're gonna make our yeast mixture. I like to do this step separately because I wanna make sure my yeast is alive and active. Otherwise, all my hard work goes to waste. You're gonna take about 3/4 cups or 190 mls of warm water. Make sure it's lukewarm. To which we're gonna add about 1 packet or 7 grams of dry active yeast. Also, we're gonna add about 1.5 tablespoons of sugar. This really adds to the bread's flavor. Stir everything up, make sure it's all properly combined, and let it sit for 5 minutes. For kneading this bread, I'm going to transfer everything into a stand mixer. You can knead this by hand, but using a stand mixer always gives me consistent results. I'm going to add in about 1.5 teaspoons of salt. You can always tweak this recipe and put more or less according to your taste. Give everything a gentle mix before we add in our oil. I'm going to add about 2 tablespoons of olive oil. 1/2 cup or 125 milliliters of warm milk. You have to make sure it's warm, otherwise your result won't turn out as great. Next, you want to add in your yeast mixture. If your yeast activated properly, it should look something like this, milky and frothy. Go ahead and add that into your flour. Then we're going to go ahead and start kneading the dough. If you're going to knead this, knead it by hand for about 8 to 10 minutes. If you're using a stand mixer, then knead for about 5 minutes. While kneading, you want to add about 2 tablespoons of butter. This recipe uses a standard bread recipe, which is flour, yeast, sugar, water, but changing a few things like adding warm water and doing some few minor tweaks here and there really changes the outcome of this bread. This bread becomes really soft and chewy, but if you put it in the oven and toast it, it's really crispy at the same time. Once you're done kneading, the dough should be really soft. If it's not, then you still need to knead some more. Next, you want to knead your dough one more time with your hands. You want to shape it into a round ball. At this point, you want to add some oil to it so that it doesn't stick to the bowl. Also, remember to cover your dough. Either use a wet cloth or a cling wrap. Otherwise, your dough will dry out and it's not going to be pretty. And you're going to go ahead and let it rise for at least 60 to 90 minutes or 1 hour to 1.5 hours. After 1 hour, your dough should have doubled in size. If it did not, then let it stay in a warm place for another 30 minutes. Next, you want to knead the dough one more time by hand and shape it into something like a submarine shape. We're gonna divide this into 5 equal pieces. If you wanna measure them, they're about 180 grams each. Anywhere between 170 grams to 200 grams should be ideal weight for making this bread. At this point, I'm gonna turn each piece into a dough ball. Next, we're finally ready to shape our bread. They look like a submarine sandwich, but ideally in the world, they're referred to as French baguettes. To start shaping, you want to turn your dough ball into a circle. For a smoother and finer texture, you can use a rolling pin to stretch out the dough. But if you don't have a rolling pin, don't worry about it, just use your hands. Then you want to roll your bread in a cigar shape. Just make sure you're evenly rolling it, otherwise the bread could get fat from one side. By fat, I meant puffy. At this point, I'm gonna transfer everything into a baking tray. Now, I am using these bread molds that I bought from Amazon. These molds really help the bread rise a lot evenly, which in turn makes it a lot softer from inside and more fluffier. I highly recommend that you do order one if you can. If not, that's fine. Just do it the old-fashioned way. Now we're gonna let our bread rise. We're gonna wait for about at least 30 minutes to 1 hour. After 30 minutes to 1 hour, you should see that your dough has proved, it has doubled in size, and you're ready to bake it. But before we bake it, we want to add some slashes to this bread. I always wondered why there were always slashes on the bread. Well, actually, this step is called scoring the bread. Scoring the bread helps it rise even nicer in the oven. Finally, you want to apply some egg wash to the bread, as doing this will give our bread a golden color. If you don't like eggs, just apply a milk wash instead. You want to bake this at 350 degrees Fahrenheit or 180 degrees centigrade for 18 to 20 minutes. If you followed all my steps, your bread should look just like this. I personally think this is like one of my best bread recipes ever. The bread rised pretty nicely. The color is really nice and golden. It's evenly cooked from all sides, really firm and nice from outside, but really chewy and moist from inside. Here's what it looks from inside. Even when I press it, it still holds its shape. After baking my bread, I decided to make some Subway style sandwiches at home. If you do want the recipe for this, let me know in the comments below and I'll make another video. But here's a quick version on how I did it. You want to start by slicing the bread from the middle and then add in your chicken. Next, you want to add your favorite type of cheese. In this case, I'm using mozzarella cheese. And you want to quickly toast your bread for 3 to 5 minutes or until the cheese melts. After that, use some aluminum foil or a parchment paper and start assembling your sandwich. Put your favorite types of vegetables. I used lettuce, onion, tomatoes, cucumber, and some jalapenos. Add your favorite type of dressing and you're done. I used parchment paper to cover my sandwich, but when you're eating at home, you really don't need to do that. But here's what it looks like from inside. This is really delicious. I couldn't believe once I made it at home how easy it was to do and really delicious. In my opinion, this homemade sandwich was way better than the Subway sandwich, but that's just my opinion. You guys should try it out and decide for yourselves too. In the end, I'm happy with how this recipe turned out. I hope you guys enjoyed this one. I look forward to hearing your feedback in the comments below. I upload new videos every Thursday. Do remember to subscribe if you enjoyed this video.